Hello, BSc second year students, please listen here carefully and try to remember. After a gap from today, we will start our syllabus, work from home. Dear students, I was in the short term course regularly online. That is the reason why our period was stopped. So anyway, now listen here. Today we will start the chapter second from our syllabus. And name of that chapter is Evidences of Organic Evolution. Manje, organic evolution ye kasa jhala, tyache purave, evidences, that is also called as the proof. Proof is called as the evidences or support to the organic evolution. Organic means organisms. And evolution manje utkranti. Organism chi utkranti kashi jali. Manje prani ani vanaspati yanchi utkranti kashi jali. So before this chapter number 2, we have already completed the chapter number 1st, and that was introduction to the theories of organic evolution. So in that chapter we have studied different theories of organic evolution. First we have studied the Lamarckism, that is Lamarck's theory of organic evolution. Second, we have studied the Darwinism, means Darwin's theory of organic evolution. Then new Darwinism, then Hugo de Vries theory. So different theories about the evolution of organisms we have already studied. I am just revised here, revision. Now how the organisms are evolved, what is the support, what is the proof, what is the evidences about the organic evolution is in today's chapter, that is evidences. Remember, evidences manje support, purave kiwa proof. Kasya sati? Organic evolution sati. Ki organic evolution kasa jala? Organic manje evolution of organism. And you know organism is plants or animals. Organism matlyananta, organism ha shabda mogham ahe. Organism may be plant, organism may be animals. In the zoology, we will study in the sense of animals. So this is the proof in the favor of organic evolution. Evidences of organic evolution means the proof in the favor of organic evolution, and there are several evidences, there are several supports or several proof about the organic evolution or evolution of organisms. So that evidences, several evidences, anek evidences hai. So we have to study here the evidences which is given in our syllabus. So dear students, syllabus I have already sent in YouTube link or in a lecture PDF file on WhatsApp group. So you write that syllabus on the first page of register. First we have to write the syllabus. What is our study? What is our course? What is our paper number? What is our paper name? That things we have to write first on your register. For this semester, make the separate register. Another register. For semester 4. Method is the previous. Half of the part for my paper and half of the part of that register for the another paper. Your another paper number. You have to make 3 registers. In that 3 registers, you make the 2 parts. One part for one paper, another part for another paper of a optional subject, zoology. So, as per the syllabus, there are several evidences, but as per the syllabus, morphological and anatomical evidences we have to study. First number is the morphological and anatomical evidences. Morphology means the external structure and anatomy is the internal structure. That we have to study morphological and anatomical evidences. Now, another evidences which is given in the syllabus, so that is embryological evidences. Embryological support, embryological proof. All the animals are evolved from single ancestors. Then another evidences is physiological and biochemical evidences. Another evidences is paleontological evidences. And last, that is the fourth, is the taxonomical evidences as per the syllabus. आपले जे अभ्यासक्रम नेमून दिलेला आहे त्या अभ्यासक्रमामध्ये 5 वेगवेगळ्या टाइपचे इव्हिडन्सेस पुरावे उत्क्रांतीच्या सिद्धांताला जे सपोर्ट पाहिजे आहे की प्राण्यांची किंवा ऑर्गॅनिझमची उत्क्रांती कशी झाली इव्होल्यूशन कसं झालं सो वी विल स्टडी हियर द फर्स्ट दैट इज मॉर्फोलॉजिकल and anatomical evidences about the evolution of organisms. So here, this morphological and anatomical evidences, it gives the proof of organic evolution or evolution of organisms. Here, animals in zoology. So, this study we have to do by the study of homologous organs, analogous organs, and vestigial organs. That is morphological and anatomical evidences of evolution. So here, the homologous organs. Homologous organs mean the organs in animals, those structure are similar, but functions are different. Homologous organs means the organs which is structurally similar but functionally different. Their functions are different and structures are similar. Remember here, the structure are similar but functions are different. Here, so such type of evolution is called as the divergent evolution. Homologous organs, this type of evolution is called as the divergent evolution. Here, the best example for understanding the four limbs of terrestrial vertebrates. Four limbs of the amphibians, four limbs of reptiles, four limbs of eels, and four limbs of mammals, especially man. So here, in the frog, the four limbs are used for hopping, and lizard, four limbs of lizard used for creeping. forelimbs of ears and bats are used for flying in the air, and forelimbs of whales are used for swimming in water, and the forelimbs of man is used for gripping and eating. Remember, forelimbs means what? So forelimbs means the, in our mother tongue, putche pai, front legs. In animals, forelimbs and hind limbs, two types of limbs, putche pai and magche pai. Gai madhe putche pai, magche pai. Janavara madhe putche pai, magche pai. Four limbs, putche. So the four limbs are structurally similar, but functionally different. Their functions are different. So here, the in frog, four limbs, putche pai cha upyog kasha sathi? Hopping. Lizard madhe, sarpatnare prane madhe, putche pai cha upyog creeping sathi. Eos madhe, paksha madhe, ani bats madhe, vatvagri madhe. Four limbs are used for flying in the air. हवेमध्ये उडण्यासाठी. व्हेल्स मध्ये देवमासा पाण्यामध्ये असणारा मॅमल्स पुढच्या पायाचं रूपांतर कशामध्ये झालं तर स्विमिंग साठी पाण्यामध्ये पोहण्यासाठी वल्हवण्यासाठी. आणि माणसामध्ये पुढच्या पायाचं रूपांतर कशामध्ये झालं तर इन द हँड्स अँड दॅट इज यूज्ड फॉर द ग्रिपिंग. इन मंकी ऑल्सो यूज्ड फॉर द ग्रिपिंग. And that is also used for the eating. Forelimbs are modified for gripping, for eating, not only for eating, for doing the work also. To do the work. आपल्याला देवाने हात कशासाठी दिलं तर काही विद्यार्थ्यांचं उत्तर असतं खाण्यासाठी. फक्त खाण्यासाठी हात दिलेले नाही देवाने आपल्याला. ईश्वराने आपल्याला हात जे आहे ते फक्त खाण्यासाठी दिले नाही, काम करण्यासाठी दिलेलं आहे, मेहनत करण्यासाठी दिलेलं आहे, पकडण्यासाठी दिलेलं असं ग्रिपिंग. इन द मॅमल फॉर एक्झाम्पल, इन द मंकी दे आर ग्रिपिंग द ब्रांचेस ऑफ द ट्रीज, दे आर फॉर ग्रिपिंग, फॉर इटिंग, फॉर डुईंग हार्ड वर्क्स इन ह्युमन बीइंग्स. नाउ दिस इज सफिशियंट अबाउट द होमोलॉगस ऑर्गन्स. नाउ अनदर टाइप्स ऑफ द ऑर्गन्स, दॅट इज द अनालॉगस ऑर्गन्स. Now, this is different from the homologous organs. How different you see here? Structurally different. Analogous organs are structurally different, but functionally similar. That's a function similar. It's a function different. It's a function similar. It's a structure similar. It's a structure different. So, exactly opposite to the homologous organs. Analogous organs are exactly opposite to the homologous organs. So here, analogous organs means the organs which structurally different but functionally similar. Now, the wings of insects, you know, insect is a non-chordate invertebrate animal. But the wings are used for flying in the air. Similarly, the wings of the eels and wings of the bat, vatvagri, they are used for flying in the air. किड्यामध्ये किड्यामध्ये इन्सेक्ट मध्ये बटरफ्लाईज मध्ये पाकुळी ज्याला आपण म्हणतो तिच्यामध्ये अनेक किड्यामध्ये पंख असतात. पंख, विंग्स फॉर फ्लाइंग. सो इन इन्सेक्ट्स, इन इन्व्हर्टिब्रेट एनिमल्स, इन नॉन कॉर्डेड एनिमल्स देर आर विंग्स, अँड इन द कॉर्डेड एनिमल ऑल्सो, इन द बॅट, in the birds, wings are there. So that wings are structurally different but functionally similar. They are used for flying in the air. Now another organ, that is the vestigial organ. Remember, this homologous organ, this analogous organ and this vestigial organs are given in our syllabus. So vestigial organs means the organs which is present in the body but it is not functional. It is functionless. There is no function. There is no responsibility to do the function. but it is present in the body. So such organs are called as the vestigial organs, and it is vermiform appendix in the body of man. Aplya body madhe, pratyekacha body madhe, appendix present asti. It is attached to the intestine. It is somewhat like this size, attached to the intestine. It is not useful in the human beings. When animal was herbivorous, man was herbivorous. So that time it is used for to digest the cellulose, which is from the plants. But in the human being, mano prana madhe, the vermiform appendix is non-functional or functionless. So that is the vermiform appendix. Similarly, the coccyx. So it is, the coccyx is present in the bone here, in the hip bone, and that is the tail vertebrae. This is the coccyx, is the tail vertebrae which is in the man, in the human beings. So dear students, for today it is sufficient what we have studied today. So today we have started the evidences of organic evolution, or evidences of the evolution of organisms. So there are five types of the evidences. Out of that, first evidence is the morphological anatomical. In that we have studied the homologous organs, we have studied the analogous organs, and we have studied the vestigial organs. So dear students, you see the video of today's lecture and send immediately your attendance. Attendance is very important. Whenever there is a period on WhatsApp group or YouTube lecture, so you immediately send your attendance. Simply your name and surname. Don't write your father's name. Your name and your surname, and say present, sir. Send your present. And from today we will start the regular period. So say to your friends, do the contact, mobile contact. You are having the numbers, mobile numbers of your friends. So see the WhatsApp group and YouTube lecture as early as possible. Thank you very much.